Okay guys, so what we're doing here at the moment today is Joe and Keith are giving me a hand getting this floor down. It's always a bit of a two-man job. The way we do it is, if you can imagine where this sheet comes across on this joint, I have seen people, which is fine, evidently you can, but it's something that we don't do, is we like to make sure there's a noggin at every join line here. So what we would do, as we run the relevant sheets through, we make sure there's a row of noggins. Now you can see that other thing coming through here. The other thing that we do is make sure there's a perimeter noggin on there as well. So see where this join is here? Underneath that, there's a noggin, which then runs all the way along there, and then it's screwed then to the joist to make it nice and solid, okay?
We've pinged the line central to where the edge of the board is gonna fit, all the way across there. So we're fitting noggins down that way, flat side along, just going the whole way running along, so that will carry the edge of the board. The end of the board is gonna finish just across here, as you can see, we've put an extra noggin in, going down there, that will carry along the edge of the board, ready to be glued and screwed.
The one thing that we do is we use certain screws and certain glue. Now there's loads of different versions, different makes, but that's the one that's our local merchant. The other thing that we do use is Spax screws. Now the one thing I can say to you, definitely shop around for the price on this, and the price on these, because I tell you what, you can save yourself anything from two to four or five quid on this, and you can save easily 2.5-3 quid with this. And the other thing is with these as well, these are quite difficult to get hold of. You can't normally just go into your local merchant and grab them. The one merchant we found this the cheapest was Ironmongery Direct, and we've literally got a load more boxes arriving today. I don't like to just put a couple of screws in. Actually, when I'm doing my board, I like to make sure we fully screw it as we're doing the relevant boards, as we put the glue down. As the glue's expanding, it could slightly push the board, and that's why I always get fixings in. So basically these screws here, Spax screws, they're really, really cool. You can see them actually. If you don't use these screws, now obviously you've got to use a 60mm screw. This is a 4.5mm gauge screw. You can use annular ring shank nails, but the problem I find with them, even though they're ribbed all the way along here, because of the moisture content, a lot of the material that arrives, it always sort of moves and twists and buckles a little bit, and in time it then starts to squeak. Whereas these, because it's a screw, it's a different kettle of fish. So, you know, me personally, we always like to screw it with this. Before these were invented though, we used to use 60 or 70mm number 5 screws. We used to countersink, didn't we?
Yeah.
We used to drill it, countersink it, so we sunk the head down nice and flush. But obviously Spax came up with these some years ago, and as soon as they did, we flipped with these because they're just really, really good. The other thing is that when we're gluing down as well, we go mental with glue. We probably go use too much glue, but you can't have enough glue as far as I'm concerned. We'll run a glue on the top of this tongue, okay? Now, because this is a 3-inch joist, we'll actually put two beads down here. If it's a 50mm joist, I'd just put one bead straight down the middle, but it'd be a nice thick bead, okay? And then any noggins, cross noggins like this, we'll put glue down here. We'll also then put glue on here as well. And then the other thing that we will do is, if you can imagine, don't like to not glue the bottom of the groove. So what will happen is that we'll actually get that glue and we'll run it into the bottom there as well. So we know that when we're actually putting the board in and we've got glue then on the top of the tongue and the top of the groove, and obviously then we've got loads of glue on here, loads of glue on there, loads of glue on there. Literally then just get it all then screwed up, and we put a screw in here, a screw at 200, 200, 200. So we've got four screws in every board. So if you work it out here, we've got easily something like 30 to 32 screws to the board. The other thing is this make, actually on the bottom of this, it sort of says this way down. So if you don't have any writing on the back telling you which way to put it up or down, it's always making sure this tongue is always up. Okay guys, if you can imagine, when you come to put this board in, you need to make sure you climatize your board as well. So there was a load of this board in here and next door, and it had been in this room for about 5 or 6 days just to give it acclimatized to this space. The other thing is you've got to be careful of, if you can imagine, when you're hacking these boards around, you're moving around site, you might dink the end, or you might end up banging this groove. And the one thing you've got to be careful of is that you don't get shit in there, or snots in there, or a broken piece. When you're trying to then bang it, you've got loads of glue everywhere. You don't want to be then getting your hands covered in glue. I mean, you can see these guys, we've been gluing all this down. We've moved a load of plasterboard up. And the real key, you just take your time, don't get no loads of glue all over you, because this stuff, if it gets over you, is horrible, isn't it, mate?
Yeah,
it's like, oh, just black stains all on your hands. It's a nightmare to get off. And if you just take your time with it and just be methodical, then that's the way forward. You'll see these guys smash this floor down. They do a cracking job.
Yeah, so when you put your noggin in, obviously you're trying to get a really straight line. Put the noggin up to it so you can kind of eye the line and tap the other. It should be a nice fit like that. You don't want it to be too much pressure putting it in there. You just want it to fit in perfectly so you're not bending the beams out either way. One, do one side at a time as well. You don't want to be trying to hammer both sides down flat, because as you drill in, one side might come up and you'll just be wasting time, really. Obviously, you want to have a good anchor in, make sure that you screw it in really, really well. Now that side's in, you know that it's not going anywhere. You can now work on getting this side flush with the other beam. See, normally, if you didn't have one of these in the other way, you could just come straight through there, but that's a bit of a tight gap, so I'm just going to pull it back in through the other way. So another thing, if you're fitting noggins and you've got a really small area to work in like that, it's going to be hard to file it through and actually manage to get screwing in that angle. It is doable, you can do it, no problem. Another thing to do, come in from the other side, screwing through into that, dip. All that's going to do is pull it in nice and tight, so you're going to have no movement on that at all. So, to paint a scenario for you, if you've got a floorboard in between two joists, there's something that you can do to get around it. So this is where the board would come up to. As you can see, it's flying over there. It's got absolutely nothing to sit on, no anchor point, which means it could rattle around a little bit. Get yourself a bit of 6x2, 4x2, something like that. Whatever you've got that you think will work, this is what we're using now. You want to put it in this way. You don't want it flat or anything, just so you've got a better anchor point coming in from that point for this bit of 2x4 to carry it. Got to secure this into this flat piece of 2x4 here. You always want to get top and bottom as well. You don't want to just leave it flapping around on the bottom there. Not that it's going to move, but that's not going anywhere. Thank you, mate. So the next thing we're putting in is a flat piece of 2x4 just to carry the edge of that board. So, say the board comes to about there. Obviously we're not going to glue and screw now, but if you're going to, always make sure you clean these down. You do not want any mud on them or any bits and bobs that are going to get in the way or stop you from having a real good fixing on this. So give that a quick brush off. Probably better to get a hoover in these gaps as well to make sure there's nothing in the tongue and groove there. And another thing to say, before these boards are actually screwed down, they are insanely slippy. So if you walk over them, be really, really careful because they can just go out. As you can see, now we have a correct fitting. We have something to really, really anchor this board down to when we glue and screw it. It was flapping about before, but now that is solid. Another thing to keep in mind is you want to leave a little gap around the perimeter there for the board to push up against. Best way to do that is make yourself some packers out of a little bit of wood. Easier than measuring it and trying to wiggle it around, so you can just stick these in like I have there, push the board up against it. You know you're 10 mil away, so no worries. When you put your glue down here and you push your board up, you want to remember where these fixings are going to be. So what I've done is I've gone along, made a little pencil notch just along the centre of each side so that when I need to put the screws in, I know exactly where the centre of this beam is so that I'm not screwing through into nothing. What I like to do is then just grab my pencil and just whip the whole way down it. That means that when I glue it, I'm not going to be gluing over the edge and getting in the way of when I lay the next board. As you can see, obviously I've made this pencil line down here so that I know I've got to get glue down in that area. Really important that you glue in both parts of the groove. You want to get plenty in there. It doesn't matter if when you're pushing this up, if any of the glue squeezes out, just let it dry. You can scrape it off later. And just drop it up there. Yeah, if you clap it in towards me. Other thing when tapping these in, you want to make sure you don't have a curved edge, because you're just going to slip up and over. You have a nice flat piece of timber. Put it above the groove on that stronger piece there. Really good. Tap, now on your side, mate. Good, yeah, you want to start seeing the glue squeeze out a little bit on the edges there. Where that beam is. Don't really need to draw across there, but just so that we don't miss. Quick pencil line. Center of the beam, up to the mark that I made previously. Right there, center of the beam. Just marking on that to where the board ends. So 200 centers, let's see how that'll work out. Really, you could do this before you put the board down as well. Save yourself a little bit of time. All right, get yourself a nice load of these back screws. Then all you need to do is head down the marks that you've got. Now there's no need to go too far into this, you just want a nice flat screw head on there so you can't feel it when you run your hand over it. And when you're doing this, you want to keep your weight on the board as well to make sure all of that glue is pushed down. Right then guys, we're going to crack on with the rest of these, get this noggin out, ready for the rest of the board to go down, and you'll see it on the time lapse. Right then guys, as you can see from watching the time lapse, we've finished putting down the chipboard floor. It's all glued, screwed, ready to go and move on to the next phase, which is plying the ensuite bathroom. If you've liked this video, please remember to like, comment and subscribe. My name's Joe, you've been watching Build With A&E.